be done using only the laser, means laser techniques. We just apply a small amount of the electric field, then it will be stored, and it can be recovered and used as a energy storage materials. Here, it is so hysteresis loop. First fundamental questions come: why hysteresis loop? Any piezoelectric materials are ferroelectric materials. Even it is also true for the magnetism. You are aware about the ferromagnetic. In ferromagnetic, there is a domain. Same fashion in ferroelectric, there is also domain, and which have a some dipole moment. Let us suppose it is oriented along this direction. And in virgin case, when we are not apply any electric field, it is a random way, and such that it has a minimum value. If you see this P, dipole moment is in this direction, but it is the opposite direction. First question arises, why it is this? Because if you know it wants a minimum energy to stabilize. As we know, any materials want to stabilize, and it can be only stabilized when it is the ground state energy. Ground state energy is nothing but it's the minimum energy. When two charge in the opposite directions, then it is cancels through this thing. As a result, it will not increase in energy. But when you supply an electric field, then it's aligning the one direction, and when just reduces it, again it is aligned in the second direction, and this is caused the loss of the energy. It please note it is known as hysteresis loop, and it is valid for magnetic material as well as ferroelectric materials. Then fundamental question arise here, that what is the difference between piezoelectric, pyroelectric and ferroelectric materials? Then I just want to clarify here, piezoelectric, pyroelectric and ferroelectric materials. Ferroelectric is the subset of pyroelectric, and pyroelectric is the subset of the piezoelectric. Means all materials which is ferroelectric is also, it is not necessary to the pyroelectric. And pyroelectric material is a piezoelectric, but converse is not true. Means if you just take a piezoelectric materials and ferroelectric materials, our ferroelectric materials is the piezoelectric, but all piezoelectric materials is not ferroelectric. For example, just you take as a quartz. Quartz is the piezoelectric material, but it is not a ferroelectric materials. Then question arise, what is the difference between piezoelectric materials and ferroelectric materials? Piezoelectric materials are the materials where each has a non-centrosymmetry, and when we just apply if pressure, then it show a dipole moment. However, for ferroelectric materials, without apply any external field or any external stimuli, it has a permanent spontaneous polarization. Therefore, it is known as, it is the signature of the ferroelectric materials. Secondly, if I just use a one word, is the anti-ferroelectricity in my title. Therefore, just in my talk, therefore, just I want to clarify what does mean by the anti-ferroelectricity. If you just see, here is the four subcells. Let us suppose dipole moment is one cell is that around this direction, and second is around this direction. If this is the T is less than TC, and you only just not apply any a electric field. And for greater than TC,